Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how easily you can change the look of the Angular Dialog component using the template property. Look at this example, where you can see the message dialog with a customized header, footer, and content. Now, I will show you how to achieve this customization at the code level. First, I will open an existing Angular Dialog application, where I have already configured the Angular Dialog with basic properties. And I also imported required module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Popups package. In case you want to know how to add a dialog to an Angular application, I have linked the Getting Started video in the above YouTube card. You can also find its link in the description below. I have defined a few CSS styles within this style section. Now, I will run this application using the command ng-serve. The Angular Dialog component is rendered with the defined height and width. Next, I am going to add a header and customize it by adding an image. To do that, first, I create a template using the ng-template tag and assign it to a template reference variable header. I add an image element with the class attribute. I want to show Syncfusion logo in the header, so let me add source path for image using source attribute. And I will set alternate name for the image. Then, I define a division element with ID and class attributes to add header for the dialog. Here, I will set the header content as Syncfusion. Next, I plan to close the dialog, so I need to define a Boolean variable, closeIcon, and set its value as true. Now, I will assign this variable to the showCloseIcon property of the dialog component. Along with this, I define few CSS styles within this style.css file. I have defined these CSS styles for the purpose of customizing the header image and close button icon. When you look at the dialog now, you can see the logo and the header content as Syncfusion. Next, I will show you how to add content to the dialog component. I want to add content for the dialog, so I create a template using the ng-template tag and assign it to a template reference variable, content. Then, I define division and span elements with class attribute. For this span element, I add appropriate content for the dialog. Also, I define few CSS styles for these classes dialog content and dialog text. Looking at this dialog, the content is added here. Next, I will show you how to add a footer and customize it. First, I define the template using the ng-template tag and assign it to a template reference variable, footer template. I want to add a text box and a subscribe button. To add a button, first, I need to install the button package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularbuttons --save. As I have already installed the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, I need to import the button module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Buttons package. I also register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Now, I make changes in the app component HTML file by adding the Angular button component with a CSS class property inside the division element. I set the button text, subscribe. I want to set the button type as information, so I assign this eInfo class to the CSS class property. Next, I need to add the text box for the dialog to get the email address. Therefore, let me define an input element of type text. Then, I add a placeholder property for the text box component to display a short description about the input field. Along with this, I import material theme for the text box component and define a few CSS styles for the footer template. And now, you can see the dialog displayed with a text box to get the email address and subscribe button in the footer. In this video, you have seen how to customize the appearance of the Angular Dialog control using the template option. If you would like to see this working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also grab a free license key to use our complete Angular suite if you fit our community guidelines. So check the link in the description to see if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching.